Ever wonder how lizards are able to climb on completely vertical surfaces? Wouldn't it be cool if we could walk up walls like geckos? It could soon be a possibility. At multiple universities in the United States, including Stanford and MIT, as well as some private companies, research is being done on this ability that geckos have. Different organizations are using that research for slightly different reasons or products, but the one thing they all have in common is adhesion. Adhesion that is strong, easily detachable, and doesn't leave any residue after being pulled off.
Modeling adhesive materials after gecko feet is one of the many examples of biomimetics. The ability to climb walls or ceilings, to scale buildings even, has been a feature of countless spy movies, and because of the biomimetics of gecko feet, it's becoming a reality. Two overarching concepts explain how geckos have their adhesive quality: fibrillar features and draping adhesion. Until recently, the fibrillar aspect of geckos' feet was thought to be the primary contributing factor to their adhesiveness. Gecko toes have hundreds of ridges called lamella. On each lamella lie tiny hairs called setae. Each setae splits further into thousands of microscopic tips called spatulae. When these setae come in contact with a surface, their molecules, and specifically electrons, interact to create an electromagnetic attraction that adheres the two surfaces through van der Waals forces. The second key factor of a gecko's ability to climb walls lies in draping adhesion. Draping adhesion's key to success lies in the ability of the material, or in this case the gecko's feet, to maintain its stiff shape while also having conformal contact with the surface it is sticking to. In other words, their feet can come in total contact with the surface and almost fit to the shape of the surface while their tendons maintain their same shape and stiffness in all the directions in which the force is applied. The concept is a little contradictory. Their feet are soft so as to increase contact and conform to the shape of the surface, but still achieve high compliance when loaded by keeping the structure of the stiff tendons.
The fabrication of gecko-inspired adhesives begins with the creation of the mold that the setae will be made from. First, a light-sensitive photoresist is applied to a silicon wafer. The system is covered with a photomask, an opaque plate that has transparent holes arrayed in the desired pattern. The wafer is then exposed to intense light, which removes the resist in the desired pattern, essentially making a regular array of holes. To apply this pattern to the silicon mold itself, the material is bombarded with ions. This process is called a deep reactive ion etch. Once the mold is created, a fluorocarbon is applied, and PDMS is poured over the mold in a vacuum and hardened. It can then be removed from the mold, leaving only the setae. Fluorocarbon is used to lower the surface energy of the mold, allowing the polymer to be removed easily without breaking either component. This process allows the length, diameter, and spacing of the setae to be controlled. The adhesives are primarily made of two layers: the stiff fabric base, replicating the stiff tendons in real gecko toe pads, and the soft polymer layer. Polydimethylsilazane, or PDMS, is a useful material in this application for several reasons. The organic methyl groups have relatively low surface energy, allowing the polymer to flow over itself. This is an important factor in the material's flexibility, making it ideal for filling molds. The silicon-carbon bond is short and relatively strong, making PDMS durable as well as flexible. These two properties make PDMS very stable or inert. The combination of being cheap, flexible, and stable make this polymer ideal for a variety of nanotechnology-related applications.
Gecko skin is a macroscopic adhesive. Gecko-inspired adhesives are made of a contradictory combination of materials: stiff fabric with a soft elastomer. Engineers maximize the softness of the elastomer to increase the true contact between the adhesive and the surface, but they balance that with the stiffness of the fabric to achieve higher loads. However, their properties undermine each other. The stiff fabric can be carbon fiber or Kevlar, which are known for their high strength to weight ratio, rigidity, fatigue resistance, tensile strength, and brittleness. On the other hand, PDMS can be used as elastomers because they are polymers that can be tailored to be softer and act like viscous liquids to be conformable, adaptable, and durable. These adhesives can have a shear adhesion strength of 29.5 newtons per square centimeter, which exceeds the adhesive strength of polymeric-based dry adhesives. In comparison, the front 2 feet of the Tokay gecko have a shear adhesion strength of around 10 newtons per square centimeter. The gecko-inspired adhesives maintain their strength when reused by being made of elastic materials and relying on reversible van der Waals interactions all over the interface of the adhesive. These interactions increase the overall force of adhesion. To achieve high shear adhesion strength and release by a transverse load, a synthetic fabric tendon in the center of the adhesive directs the applied force to the center instead of the edge. What sets gecko-inspired adhesives apart from traditional adhesives is that they rely on draping adhesion instead of viscoelastic adhesion. Draping adhesion maximizes conformal contact with the surface while having a high Young's modulus, so there is sufficient elastic stiffness in directions that forces are applied. Viscoelastic adhesives are typically soft and gooey, like honey, syrups, or gels. Viscous fluids resist flow, so they are effective adhesives. Viscoelastic adhesives can also return to their original shape. However, they cannot withstand as much pressure as draping adhesives.
With the research and development that has been done already, organizations have been able to make an adhesive mimicking gecko feet with a shear adhesion of 29.5 newtons per centimeter squared, basically saying it can hold a lot of weight, easily enough to hold a person onto a Waal. For comparison, the shear adhesion of the two front hands of a gecko is 10 newtons per centimeter squared. The biggest limitation to the products created thus far is that they are all flat surfaces, like pads or strips. Nobody has created gecko gloves that people can wear to walk up Waals.
The phenomena behind the adhesiveness of gecko feet is a concept widely investigated by researchers. From the chemical reactions of CT to drape adhesion, more is being discovered to develop and improve technologies. In the past, adhesive materials have been based on viscoelasticity, achieved by using gooey, shapeless material that takes force to stick and unstick from a surface, leaving residue. New adhesive technologies, on the other hand, are utilizing structure and softness to allow a material to detach without residue or much force. The future of adhesives incorporating these properties of gecko feet opens the door to endless possibilities, including shaping the future of the military by allowing troops to use inventions such as usable adhesive gloves that allow you to scale Waals. We've really just begun discovering the capabilities of adhesion modeled on gecko feet.